I've been noted by many people who watch my videos that I don't talk about gay men in anime as much as I talk about gay women in anime. Now, while this is because I am a transgender lesbian, I can find truth in this statement. I'm someone who doesn't really like yaoi slash BL anime because of the problematic tropes that are featured in a lot of them. Actually, most of my favorite gay men characters come from non-yaoi anime, and I'm gonna cut down my favorite here. Let's continue to celebrate Pride Month with my top 10 gay men in anime. Number 10. Liron from Gurren Lagann. Now, while Liron might seem like the stereotypical flamboyant gay man character in anime, there is a lot more to him than meets the eye. While we do get one or two jokes about the male characters being a little creeped out by Liron's advances, they are so small and don't leave any impact at all. Liron serves as a mechanic of Team Gurren and helps to fix and improve the team's various Lagans. He is perhaps the smartest character in the cast, always having a solution to solve the problem. Hell, he is mostly the reason why they are able to understand and operate the bigger Lagans that they get every so often. And it's satisfying when he boards his own Lagan and join the final fight. He has a solution to everything, and he's usually the character to speak the exposition that is needed to understand the current situation of the battle. He also isn't stereotypical over-the-top gay, which anime do sometimes that makes it a little insulting, if you know what I mean. He's a mechanic of the team that everyone can rely on to figure out a solution that'll save the day.
It's called a sense of humor, honey. Time you got one.
Number 9. Kanji from Persona 4 The Animation. I'll be the first one to admit that the Persona series is not a progressive series. It's a series created by men for men. So the way that Kanji's story arc with his gayness in the games isn't really the best. However, this story arc in the anime version of the game does things better. It doesn't go insulting Kanji's gayness, and in the anime, Kanji sort of comes to terms with it and accepts this side of him. Kanji is bisexual in both game and anime. One of the reasons showing this is that when the character thinks that Naruto is male, he has a hidden crush on him so that he doesn't tell anyone. However, when it's revealed that Naruto is female, the crush that he has towards her still remains. While I admit that some uncomfortable jokes towards Kanji's bisexuality throughout the many Persona 4 projects, it's the character himself that I enjoy so much. He's a badass guy who also has a little bit of a feminine side to him, and that's something to enjoy in a character.
We aren't trying to follow you or anything, nor do I think you might be gay! And if you are, that's totally cool too! I think that's great!
Did you say gay?
Number 8. Kunzai and Zozai from Sailor Moon. Now, these two characters in the 90s version were a lot different than their original manga counterparts. Two of the villains in the first season are actually a couple, which, again, was way different from the manga's version of the characters. But I gotta say, I like this change, as it adds some more characteristics to the two characters than before. Which is why I hate the fact that the old dub made Zoisite a woman in order to censor the gayness! Okay, calm down, Viz Media dub did it right, live with that. When it's Zoisite's turn to be the villain after Jadeite and Nephrite, he has a lot of difficulty and is continually beaten by the Sailor Guardians, so he runs to Kunzite for comfort, and Kunzite will motivate Zoisite to continue on. Also, when Zoisite dies and Kunzite becomes a new villain, he does so in the memory of his love, and when the Guardians defeat him, he refuses to refresh and instead wants to return to Zoisite's side. It's this love and dedication that I love so much about these two characters, and it was another progressive element that the 90s anime had before Harakuni Michiru even appeared on the show. Number 7. Shion and Nezumi from Number 6. While I can't really say that the anime itself is really good, as I don't like this one at all, the thing that kept me watching was the growing relationship between Shion and Nezumi. These two boys first met when an injured Nezumi arrived in Shion's room on a stormy night and Shion helped to patch him up. 4 years later, Nezumi returned the favor by saving Shion from the government and taking him with him. From this point on, their relationship grows naturally as they come to learn more and more about each other. They then start to trust each other and even share a kiss at one point, though this kissing is much more explicit in the light novels, so I've heard. Everything that they do is for each other and they bring out the best of each other. Nezumi helps Shion continue being himself and not fall into despair, and Shion helps Nezumi to become a better person and see that not everything is so black and white. What I love about this couple is two things. First is how their relationship grows naturally over time, which makes their growth much more believable. The second is that it's really rare to see a gay male couple in an anime that isn't slice of life or yaoi-centric. This is just a sci-fi anime whose two main male characters are attracted to each other, and it flows in nicely with the story and themes of the anime. I think that's pretty cool.
君に出会えてよかった。
Number 6. Ranka from Oran High School Host Club, a bisexual cross-dressing dad from my favorite anime of all time. Why do I love Ranka so much? Because he's the bisexual cross-dressing father of our heroine Haruhi Fujioka. That's why. After Haruhi's mother passed away, Ranka had to work multiple jobs to take care of the house and of Haruhi. Some of these jobs including working at a liquor store and at a gay bar. He also swore to never love another woman after his wife passed away. Men though? Maybe. One of the great things about Ranka is how the show treats him. After the initial shock of discovery, the show treats him as a caring father and willing to help the host club sometimes, like dressing Haruhi up girly for them and saving her from the Zuka Club. All of the characters treat him with respect, especially his daughter, who he loves very much. Ranka's cross-dressing might also be the reason that Haruhi doesn't care if people mistake her as a boy, as Ranka must be mistaken as a woman all the time. And that's a pretty good lesson that Ranka unintentionally teaches Haruhi. Ranka is a caring father and a pretty fun and enjoyable character. He also happens to be a bisexual crossdresser as well.
I know it's going to happen eventually. One day my precious little girl will be all grown up. And she'll want to have that special someone by her side.
Just thinking about it gets my blood boiling!
Number 5. Yakumo from Showa Ginroko Rakugo Shinju. Here's a recipe for you. Take a show that takes place before and after World War II and then during Japan's reconstruction in the mid-20th century. Then add in a character who is gay in a country where stuff like that is continued to be looked down upon more and more. You get a recipe of a closeted gay character who is so closeted that it destroys him throughout the entire series. And that's what makes him so complex. Throughout his entire life, Yakumo is forced to disguise his true self from the world and adapt as each decade goes on. Whenever Mayo Chiki forces herself on Yakumo and kisses him, you can tell that he is not into it at all, but has to force himself to do it in order to survive in his country. Yakumo is also in love with his best friend, but has to hide it, and this allows Yakumo to let him get away with a lot of things. And after his best friend's death, Yakumo is changed and never really truly lives after that. It's this complex kind of character trapped in a time period that he does not belong in that makes the character in the show so interesting to watch. And that's what makes me like this guy so much.
Number
4. Karu Nagisa from Neon Genesis Evangelion. This boy is precious. He is a precious, precious boy. Karu was originally born to do only one thing, to meet Shinji. And he loves him. Even though this was originally a ruse to get Shinji to trust him, as Karu was one of the angels, Karu actually does fall in love with Shinji, sacrificing himself to save the day in both the original anime and the third rebuild movie. Throughout the anime and the movie, Shinji cannot really be happy or trust anyone, always afraid that they'll find Shinji too cowardice and leave him behind. Karu ends up being the only one that he can trust because of how kind and caring Karu is towards him. In the third rebuild movie, thanks to Karu's piano lessons, Shinji manages to break free from his oppressive state. This features scenes that are way too gay to comprehend. And in the end, Karu is the reason that Shinji ends up getting in the goddamn robot. Now that is an accomplishment all on its own. No matter what iteration Karu is in, whether it being the anime, movies, games, and various manga, Karu is always shown with an air of mystery. But at the same time, always love Shinji. Maybe, just maybe, this precious boy will be able to survive, in the end, one day.
You are delicate like glass. That is, your heart is.
It is?
Yes. This is worth earning my empathy.
Empathy?
I'm saying I love you.
Number 3. Kasukabe and Sajo from Dokusei. From the only straight-up yaoi anime that I watched and actually really enjoyed, Dokusei has a relationship that subverts recurring yaoi tropes. For one thing, the characters don't fall into the dominant and submissive tropes that majority of yaoi anime feature. They are both equal in the relationship and are caring towards each other. There is also communication and consent between the two, usually asking the other for a kiss or makeout session instead of just forcing it on the character. I also like how these scenes are not shown inappropriately or are fetishized for a straight female audience. They are just shot and shown like any other kiss scene would be shot or shown, homosexual or not. And that's what makes me really enjoy Kasukabe and Sajo so much. one being a lazy but eccentric rock and roll player, and the other being a silent but also determined bookworm. Together they form a relationship that is presented very realistically, and that's really refreshing in the yaoi genre. They start dating, go through different trials and situations, and end up helping and loving each other in the end, all presented in a realistic way. There is also the fact that they are so goddamn cute together. All of this is what puts Kasukabe and Sajo at number 3 on this list. Now give me more Dokusei projects, goddammit!
Ah! それだ! Ah, すっきりした!
下の句の方が有名な歌なのに。変なやつ。
Number 2. Toya and Yukito from Cardcaptor Sakura. These two characters are my personal favorite gay male characters in anime. Cardcaptor Sakura is a show known for having the mission of portraying different kinds of love, for better and for worse. But one excellent love that came out of this goal was the relationship between Toya and Yukito. The two are almost always seen together throughout the anime, either at school or at their various part-time jobs. Early on in the show, we learn that there is someone that Toya secretly likes, and we also learn that the person that Yukito likes is actually Toya, telling Sakura that he'll ask him out soon. The relationship between the two of them really intensifies towards the end of the series when Toya figures out that Yukito is actually the disguised form of a being known as Yue. Toya continually tries to question Yukito about this, always being interrupted by Naruku. As Yue is starting to fade away due to Sakura's lack of magical power, Toya offers Yue his own power, at the cost of never seeing the spirit of his mother again or being able to sense when Sakura is in danger. It doesn't matter to him because he would do anything to save Yukito. Yukito, in return for Toya always looking out for him, always tries to make him happy. It's this sweet and hormonal relationship in a show targeted to young girls that makes me love the two of them so much. And whenever Toya and Yukito are in one of Clamp's multi-universe shows, they are always shown together. In each version, it's hinted that the two of them are in a relationship as well, making them Clamp's soul pair. It's a classic case of gay male love that I'll remember forever.
Yuki, omae, ore ga shiranai to omotteru kamoshinnai kedo. Iya, omae mo shiranai kamoshinnai kedo.
Number 1. Yuri and Victor from Yuri on Ice. Of course these two are going to be number 1. After all, they are the gay couple who made history. How you may ask? Well, as the 6th episode of this sports anime that seemed to have queer baiting in it and being targeted to a female audience, it pulled out a crazy twist on us that no one saw coming and surprised everyone. That twist being, they were actually gay. When the kiss happened in episode 6, the world shook at once as all fans yelled out in excitement and everyone rejoiced. And the rest is history. Talking about the characters themselves, Yuri and Victor feature a good and healthy relationship. Victor becomes Yuri's coach and they work together to get Yuri's ice skating career back and running. Victor is always encouraging Yuri out in times of need and always has his back no matter what. Yuri returns his help by showing Victor his love in his ice skating routine. As the matches go on, the two of them become closer and closer, once again leading up to the kiss in episode 6. From then on, the two of them only become closer together, eventually leading to Yuri's goddamn proposing to Victor, and everyone around the world squealed at once. Get out of here, JJ, we are having a gay moment! And while this might not be the most realistic relationship and situation, as both Japan and Russia have very negative views on homosexuality, this anime obviously takes place in a fantasy world where everyone can be happy and gay. Yuri and Victor represented a huge subversion in many sports anime targeted at straight women. That you can still have a show like this and not be queer baiting. All you have to do is go all the way and be gay. And that is the reason that Yuri and Victor will forever go down for making gay history.
I wanted to surprise you more than you've surprised me. This was the only thing I could think of. It worked.